Well, Australians are finding new ways to commemorate Anzac Day around the country. We're seeing dawn services streamed online, only small groups allowed to attend in person. Communities lighting candles in their driveways and stopping for a minute's silence at home, with bugles and trumpets sounding the last post through the streets.
Beautiful. Our team of reporters has all the details for us. And first, we're going to the Australian War Memorial in Canberra, where the National Commemorative Service was held earlier on this morning. Jonathan Kersley from Channel 9 is there. He's been with us all morning. Jonathan, tens of thousands of people normally gather there, but this morning a much smaller crowd, but a no less poignant ceremony.
Absolutely right, Richard. Very different in terms of the crowd sizes, normally 15 to 30,000. Instead, this morning for this commemorative service, not the traditional dawn service, less than 50 inside the War Memorial. But it was no less poignant, no less moving than what we have seen here year after year, as the dignitaries reflected on the efforts and respect for Australian military service personnel, but with a particular focus too on health workers, those who have been on the front line, nurses, intensive care nurses. We heard retired Wing Commander Sharon Bone talk about a stained glass window inside the Hall of Memory, which features a nurse standing under a red cross. The Prime Minister on this, what he calls Australia's most sacred day, reflected on two stories of military personnel. One, Caroline Griffith, a former reservist who is now an ICU nurse, still during this coronavirus crisis as we are forced apart. She works inside a hospital in Brisbane alongside her daughter. He also spoke about Corporal Matt Williams, a soldier who diagnosed with cancer at the age of 21, marched just 2 years ago with his chemotherapy tablets inside his top pocket. But it was a very moving service, as the Prime Minister also spoke about Australians needing to stand together while today we are so apart because of this coronavirus crisis. It's not the first time a health crisis has impacted on Australian war commemoration services. In 1919, the year after the Great War ended, Australia and the world was in the grips of the Spanish flu. Here's what the Prime Minister had to say.
On the shores of Gallipoli, where Australians landed 4 years before, a small group of Anzacs who had been arranging and tending the graves of their mates gathered, and there was no pomp at that little service. There were no dignitaries, no bands, just the sound of lapping water on a lonely shore. One said of that little service, it was the real thing.
The Prime Minister spoke there about Gallipoli. No real service, but as the sound of water lapping here this morning, mist gathering over the War Memorial as Australians are asked and urged to respect and honour Australian service personnel in private. There will be another service that Australians are invited to take part in from their lounge rooms or their driveways at 11:30. That would be 4:30 Gallipoli time when Australians landed at Gallipoli. Richard.
Jono, thank you very much. And Isabella Stashkovsky is at the Shrine of Remembrance in Melbourne for us. Isabella, just how did the community pay their respects at the shrine?
Beck, a number of people did come to the shrine this morning. It was just a handful. They had flags in their hands, and their thoughts were, of course, with the servicemen and women who gave up their lives for our country. They also said they were reflecting on the people in blue, the men and women in blue this week. Obviously, it's been a very difficult week here in Victoria. Now, I just want to show you what it looks like here this morning. The eternal flame is burning bright. A few people have come up to take a photograph and pay their respects. And the flags here are raised at half mast. Obviously, that's a tradition, but usually there would be tens of thousands of people here this morning. Still, it would be shoulder to shoulder, but there are just those few people coming up. Some have been exercising. It's quite overwhelming that they can get so close to that flame this morning. A service was held. It was the only service held in Victoria behind closed doors inside the shrine. And I did speak to some people this morning about how they felt. They said it was a somber time, but it was an incredible experience nonetheless.
It was very somber and very moving. It was done in a very dignified way.
In the face of adversity, we are drawn closer, and it's the most important, you know, element right now.
Victorians have also paid their respect through online platforms, some even using hashtags to share their message of respect and remembrance this morning.
Thank you very much indeed, Izza. Well, Sarah Stewart joins us now from Ingleburn in Sydney's southwest, where residents of all ages have been coming out to pay their respects this morning, a service like no other. Sarah, I love the fact that Anzac Day is still so meaningful to our younger generations, yeah?
Yeah, it certainly is. At about 5:45 this morning, we saw all the residents come out on the streets, and we saw kids as young as 2, they were holding their candles. They were all out here learning some of them what Anzac Day is about. And then we saw the veterans who were in charge of the service obviously celebrating what Anzac Day is about as well. They had the ode, they had the national anthem, they had the last post. And it really was a special morning out here as they all gathered. But I'm joined now by a couple of residents, 15-year-old Kai, whose grandfather served in Vietnam. Kai, what was it like for you out here this morning?
It was great. I loved seeing everyone out here. It made me really happy.
There were the candles, there was the last post, there was the ode. Did it make you think of your own grandfather, and what were you thinking?
I did think of him, and I just thought, it's great to see, you know. It's an amazing thing.
And Kerry, Mum Kerry, it was your dad. Obviously, it's... We celebrate the day, but it's also hard, isn't it? Because he's no longer with us.
Yeah, it is a bit hard. It is a bit hard, but it's brilliant. I was so happy to just see everyone out. Absolutely loved it.
And seeing him wear the medals as well?
No, that made me very proud. Yeah. The eyes were watery, everything like that. No, real proud moment. He would have been very proud of Kai.
Yeah, well, we're proud of everybody here today. As I said, everybody came out and paid their respects. And you know what? Even though we were apart, we were very much together.
It is certainly an emotional day for descendants, that's for sure. And Shannon Marshall McCormack is in Brisbane's southeast, where the Music for Mateship initiative was born. Shannon, good morning to you again. What was it like to be there?
Oh, incredibly moving, Beck. I mean, there was barely an empty driveway or front yard here this morning in Bunya Street in Greenslopes in Brisbane, as they all stood out the front to remember those who have gone before us. Alistair Tompkins, who was behind this initiative, this Music for Mateship initiative, he was actually out the front playing the last post along with his 9-year-old son, Hugo. It was the first time he'd ever performed publicly after just picking up the trumpet 6 months or so ago. But it was amazing. There were people lining the streets and they were holding candles, remembering the Anzacs and that Anzac spirit at a time when people can't get to your regular Anzac Day services. For one neighbour in particular, the widow of a World War II veteran, it was incredibly special.
My husband was in the, you know, in World War II. It's lovely. Very, it's sort of very friendly and comedy, isn't it?
Now, Alistair, the creator of that Music for Mateship movement, he hopes that this will become an annual tradition. It was also happening in streets right around Australia and even in New Zealand. Beck?
Thank you very much indeed, Shannon. Let's head to Adelaide now, where residents have lined their streets, lighting candles and paying their respects. We're going to go to our reporter, Kate Lamb. Kate, thank you for joining us. Wreaths have also been laid in quite a special way.
Yeah, they sure have. Families who made their way out onto their driveways here in Adelaide's western suburbs were also greeted by a very special parade, which took place by a lone van that's called the Kindness Combi, which actually made its way along the foreshore and played the last post on repeat through a PA system that was blaring throughout the streets. Now, along the way, they did stop at several locations to lay wreaths and pay respects to those servicemen and women who've both served in the past and present as well. The tribute certainly put a smile on many people's faces. Take a listen.
Oh, I think it's wonderful. It's wonderful. It just gets people, I don't know...
A sense of togetherness yeah. When we can't be together.
Now, of course, while this was taking place, so too was the traditional dawn service in Adelaide CBD, but on a very scaled back version with only 20 people allowed there. But South Australians are being reminded that throughout the day, they are allowed to attend their local war memorial sites if they wish to pay their respects.
OK, thank you very much, Kate. Now over to Kelly Haywood in Perth, where a community is coming together to remember Anzac Day in a very special way. Good morning, Kelly. Just what are they doing?
Good morning. Well, as you can see behind me, there's dozens of locals who have come to commemorate and pay their respects. And I'm with someone very special this morning. This is World War II veteran Kevin Jones. This is the first time he's commemorating on his driveway. We've even got some makeshift plaques of his family members, so he is still able to pay his respects here this morning. But Kevin, this is a very somber morning and a very different way to commemorate Anzac Day. How are you feeling this morning?
It certainly is different. I can't believe so much excitement, so much trouble everybody's gone to make this a great day.
Now, there's a lot of people out here to come and pay their respects to you. You know, what do you have to say to them this morning?
I'm honoured, but I think what's forgotten during the war, so many civilians suffered almost equally with the veterans, and they don't seem to get the same recognition, but I appreciate it so much.
It's a very good point. And, you know, I know this is a big question, but what does Anzac Day mean to you?
Oh, it means everything. I think it started in 1916 with Gallipoli, which was even greater than anything in World War II. But it's such an honour to be remembered for so long.
And what does it mean to you to see so many new generations and younger people, even children now, understanding how important it is to commemorate Anzac Day?
That's the part that is so amazing to me. There was a lapse several years ago, then it's over the last decade or so, it's really built up and it's getting bigger every year. It's amazing.
It certainly is, Kevin. Thank you. Now, normally we commemorate here in Perth at King's Park. There's a crowd of 30,000 strong, and then tens of thousands of people take to the streets to watch our veterans march through the CBD. But of course, this year, due to COVID-19 restrictions, we can't be doing that. But this is almost just as good. It's incredible to see so many people coming out to pay their respects to our veterans.
Kelly, those images where you are this morning are so beautiful. That community we can see behind you there holding those candles, and people just like Kevin Jones are exactly who we are all thinking about this morning. Kelly Haywood and our entire team of reporters right across the country, thank you very much. The Australian Air League is reflecting on more than 80 years of Anzac Day experiences this morning as they mark this day of remembrance with some words from their youngest cadets.
They shall grow not old.
As we that are left grow old.
Age shall not weary them.
Nor the years condemn.
At the going down of the sun.
And in the morning.
We will remember them.
Lest we forget.
Lest we forget.
Richard and Beck, I'm sure the two of you feel exactly the same. I got goosebumps before when I was listening to Kevin Jones speak. You can see just how much it means to all of those servicemen and women right across the country that these communities everywhere today in our capital cities are coming together and paying their respects on this Anzac Day. It's so beautiful.
And it's so intergenerational too. I just love the fact that the young people are getting into the spirit of my grandfather. Was at Gallipoli. I know that dates me a little bit, but, you know, we grew up on stories. They were always reluctant to talk about these things, but he was a dentist there who was doing rudimentary dental work on people there, and the stories were just harrowing, and I love the fact that the little kiddies are getting into the whole thing, because it's important.